Okay, get them list time. Ooh, I just moved my whole computer. Okay, so I kind of nerd out about the get them lists and the hot lists a little bit. Probably because you guys, like, in the beginning of my business, someone would message me that they wanted to do a party, and I would think, well, if they'll get back to me when they're ready, and I just very much put it in other people's hands. I'm tired of giving away control of my business. The other thing is I'm a little bit of a space cadet, so I would forget, but then I would stress, like, who have I forgotten? Who did I forget to message? And then because I was stressing who I was forgetting, I was over-messaging the women that weren't interested, and I was under messaging the women that were, and it was just kind of a mess. So we have get 'em lists for you. So get 'em lists are for women that maybe are interested in booking a party with you, or they are interested in joining your team. So, but maybe just right now is not a good time. Like, you'll do parties where someone's like, oh my God, I want to party with you so bad, but I am literally like right in the middle of moving and I just can't right now. But like in September, oh my gosh, that would be amazing. Here's the thing, if you don't write that shit down somewhere, you're not gonna remember, right? So if you're at an in-home party, I always make notes on my Connect cards. So I write down wants to do a party, wants to do it in September. For virtual parties, you can write it down. I write it down straight into my get 'em list. So because I'm already on, a digital format. So that's kind of how I get them down somewhere. Hell, you guys, like post-its are undervalued. You could be, writing it down on a post-it note and then put a post-it note stack on your desk or in a space and literally then take that and put them into your get them list. It doesn't matter as long as they end up in your get them list. So I'm actually going to show you guys kind of how the get them lists actually work. So in your Dropbox, if you go into, your Dropbox folder, you open this bad mamma jammer up and go to tracking. You've got get 'em lists for parties, get 'em lists for recruit leads. There is also a printable version. So if you would rather print this and have it kind of written on paper, you can. I'll be honest, y'all, I used to do this way until I had like the leader of COLA incident of 2012. So I lost all of my lists. So now I'm like, nope, I'll learn. I'll put it in Excel. It's fine. And you guys, the cool thing about these lists, they are in Excel, but they are incredibly easy to use. So we're just going to go to the My Party Leads and we're going to open this guy. And when you open it up, always check y'all for tabs along the bottom. So we've got hot list parties. So I do have some women that don't use the hot lists. They're really good at checking this on the regular. Those are rare. So I never ever use the hot list party tab, but I do use the paper hot list. So again, if you guys watch the video on the hot lists, right? All of these women that you're working with right now, eventually you want to make sure that they get onto your get 'em list. So in the get 'em list, you're actually going to put down the date that you last contacted them. So let's say I chatted with her today. Her name is, I don't know, I'm just making shit up. We talk via Facebook Messenger. She wants a virtual party. She is a lead, I don't know, let's say from my VIP group. She is interested. Oops, I'm doing this under hot list after I just said that I wasn't. So she is interested, let's say, in, she said July. So she is hot right now. Okay. I offered her the 31st and wants to get her coworkers together. So write down whatever notes that you have on her, whatever you'd like. So let's say I'm working with her. Okay. Maybe she is on my hot list, either this one or my paper one, doesn't matter. I'm working with her. Now let's say fast forward a couple days. I am in touch with her on the 28th. I'm going to change the date. Now something went down at work, right? And the party was going to be for her coworkers. She is now interested in doing her party in September. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to click the little three that highlights the whole thing. And I'm going to right click and I'm going to hit cut. I'm going to go to September and I'm going to put her by pasting in September. Okay. So the cool thing about this, let's say you have somebody else, she wants to do a July party. You're going to put her in July. You're talking to somebody else. She wants to have a party in August. You're going to put her in August. Here's what I want you guys to consider. If you keep doing this with every single lead that you meet for the next 4 years, you're going to have, right, a gazillion leads every single month that you can reach out to book parties with you. Now, I also move them. So like in September, let's say Susan is like, oh my God, I can't, back to school is insane. Like, I don't know, maybe we're still in COVID times, right? Which we will be. And she's like, everyone's at home. I just can't. Can we maybe do December? I'm going to move her again from September into December. So then I know in November, I got to hit up all my December party people, right? In December, I got to hit up all my January party people. In January, I got to hit up all my February. So as long as you stay in touch with these leads and keep moving them forward, it's also going to make sure that you're triggering a once a month contact with them. So what I, or, you know, kind of a touch base, maybe it's not once a month, but here's what I will say. If they don't respond to you, so let's say they're in your get them list, you're working your whole get them list for July. If they don't get in touch with you, you can either leave them there if you want that lead to kind of disappear and shrivel and die. Or what I do is I move her 2 months. I feel like hitting somebody up every 2 months about a party is super reasonable. You could even do every month if you wanted to. At this point though, again, she is not a hot lead if she didn't kind of engage and respond with me. So ghosting is not a no. To me, a ghosting is just not right now. So depending on how hard you want to hit your get them list, how badly you need parties, sometimes if I'm doing a big like get them list push, I might message a woman on there maybe 3 times before I decide, okay, nope, right now is not a good time. And I'll move her 2 months. So then 2 months down the line, I can see maybe she's responded, maybe she hasn't. I can just check in again and ask her, you know, are you still interested? If not, just let me know. That's cool. I'll take you off my get them list. And or off of my, you know, leads list or whatever, or just off my list, whatever it is that you're comfortable saying. So then if she still doesn't answer, though, I'm still going to move her 2 more months out. So you guys see how this list just kind of keeps building and building and building so that you always have somewhere to go to for parties. So for recruits, it's similar. It's a little bit easier because we don't have the months down at the bottom. So with your get them list for your recruit leads, there is just your hot list again, if you prefer to use them on Excel, and then you're gonna get them. So you can put them in here, and then I just keep a long-term list. So I don't have it split up by month because to me, with your recruit leads, women that wanna join your team, you have so many opportunities to reach out to them. So you can kind of do the same thing with your parties. I know some gals actually just have a one tab in their get them list for parties where they have a huge list for everybody if they don't have a specific date to reach out to them. That's completely fine too, you guys. You will get used to what works for you. The thing with, right, this system is that we want to give you the basic tools. If you need to tweak these to work better for you, do it, right? Like, do whatever you got to do to make this shit work for you. We're totally good with that. We just wanted you to have a basic system where you can put your leads in, you're triggered to actually check in with them. I even put my follow-up, my party follow-up, in my planner. So I actually write in my planner once a month. I usually do it on the 25th of every month for the next month, or the 20th, and I just write get them list. And every single month, get them list, get them list, get them list, get them list. So that's my trigger to go into my get them list and book some freaking parties. So those are the get them list, you guys. I promise you, if you keep a leads list, it will be the like number one thing that you can do for your long-term business. A lot of women look at successful consultants and they're like, well, she just books parties and she just does this and she just does. I'm like, look at, listen, it's not magic. It's just that we did what we were told. So I have leads on my list. You guys, I'm still booking parties with women from 2007, right? So I've got a lot of women on my leads list. Yes, that makes it a lot easier for me to book parties. But guess what, mama? I put in the work in 2007 when I didn't know anything about anything. And I made sure that they found their way onto a leads list. So I think that this isn't, so that you do have longer term leads. So think a little bit more long term than just trying to book them right now, right? Your book them right now is your hot list, and then your make sure you get them is your get them lists.